Today we will be repairing a microwave oven from Saturn. After a small voltage surge in the network, it stopped working. We need to figure out what the problem is. When it is turned on, it actually shows no signs of life. The backlight does not work, which means that something serious has broken. First of all, you need to unscrew the casing of the microwave oven using a cross screwdriver. To do this, you must unscrew four bolts located on the back cover. We also unscrew the first and second block from the other side on the side part of the cover. And we carefully remove the top part of the microwave casing. And slowly, with a screwdriver, we will gently pull it towards ourselves, and it will come out of its connectors. First of all, it is necessary to check all the fuses in the microwave oven using a digital or analog tester. We set the tester switch to measure resistance. And after that, we use probes in order to carefully and thoroughly check the fuse on the control board. There is actually no response or reaction, although the circuit works like this. In fact, now let's check the high current fuse that is installed on the transformer. We disconnect one terminal and then the other. Here the circuit is completely closed, which means this fuse is actually functioning properly. We then carefully remove the fuse from the control board. It literally broke in our hands. On the top of the fuse, it is visible that it is rated for 8A and a voltage of up to 250V. Before replacing the fuse, it is necessary to ensure that there is no short circuit anywhere and that all parts of the microwave oven are intact. If you have a suitable 8A fuse, that's good. But you can either go buy one at the market or make it yourself. We find in the reference book or online a table of fuse diameter ratings. In my case, it should be 8A, which corresponds to a copper wire diameter of 0.22. It is necessary to find it and solder it into the fuse. I have a fuse like this, but it is weak at 1.5A. Therefore, it is necessary to replace the wire insert, and it can be installed in the microwave. You can measure the wire diameter using a regular caliper. It is preferable for it to have a measurement accuracy of up to 0.02 meters. Let's take the wire. I found a suitable one. We carefully close the caliper and check its diameter. Cirumium, that is. And how many hundredths we will look at until they match. Here is the first, the second. Just right, indeed. 0.22 millimeters is what we need. Then with a small diameter drill, I have a 2 millimeter one here, we drill a hole on both sides of the future fuse that we will install, and we can solder the wire here. The hole has been drilled on both sides. You can very carefully solder a wire here. Lightly and thoroughly coat the sides with the soldering flux. This step is very important. And you can basically solder. We then carefully insert the new wire inside, essentially. We carefully bend it from both sides to ensure it is taut. Then we solder it well. Here, the hole is already soldered. We do the same on the other side. And this is what the fuse looks like. It's now not 1.5, but 8 amperes. Now we place the fuse back in its position. Be careful not to break it. After such a simple repair, the casing can be reinstalled. After such a nicotine repair, we can check how it works. We take a glass of cold water and place it. For 1 minute, two, and we wait. The microwave is working. Now let's check the temperature of the water in the glass. It is clear that steam is coming out, which means everything is working as it should. Thus, the repair consists of the simple replacement of fuses in most microwave ovens. It is advisable to install a good fuse because if you do not have a good caliper or micrometer, it is difficult to select the diameter of the wire.